Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson Number 21. The topic is Internal Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mubem. Let us look at the lesson goals. Today, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to define the earthquake and state the causes of the earthquake. Let's get started. The definition of earthquake, it is the sudden shaking and trembling of the earth crust rocks caused by the shock waves that originate below the surface, the earth surface. Remember now this one, it is that sudden shaking and also the trembling of the earth crust rocks. And remember, it is caused by the shock waves. And these shock waves, they come or they originate below the earth surface. Then we also have another term, earth tremors. When we talk about the earth tremors, these are mild earthquakes. Then we also have the epicenter. It is the point just above the seismic focus. Then we define the seismic focus, the point where the shock waves originate from. You can be able to see all those terms that we have talked about. The epicenter, we also have seismic focus. You also have the waves, how they move, and how the earthquake is caused. Until it goes to affect the human being, until it is felt by the human being. So you can see how it takes place. Now, let us look at the causes of the earthquake. What are the causes of the earthquake? One, it is the gravitation pressure. The gravitation pressure results to the earthquake. How? Vacuum created by the magma that have moved during the volcanicity, that vacuum now it must be occupied. Remember, the pull of gravity pulls everything towards the center of the earth. So as a result, as it has pulled, and then the crust of rock is caused to sink, that one results to the shaking or the trembling of the earth. Like you can be able to see. There is a space, then there is the collapsing, and then you can see where the earthquake is moving to. Then, another one, it is the volcanicity. How does the volcanicity result to the earthquake? This is due to the magma movement. When the magma is moving, as you can be able to see in that diagram, as it is getting its way to the crust, it causes the rocks, the crust of rocks, to move either horizontally or vertically. And as it is moving, it results to the shaking of the earth crust. Then we have the third one, which is the tectonic forces, tectonic activities. It causes the earth crust to move. We have the tectonic forces that are tension force, compression force, shear or tear force. As you can be able to see where it is operating, as the crust is forced to move towards one another, then there is that shaking of the earthquake. You can be able to see where we experience the shallow earthquakes and the deep earthquakes. You can see them. Then, the number four, it is the isostatic adjustment. The relative movement between the sea and sea as it tries to create that isostasy. It means, as it is trying to create that isostasy, it must move. So as a result, shaking or the trembling, you can be able to see from the diagram. Then we have the human activities that causes the earthquake. One, we have the construction of large reservoirs. That is one that might end up resulting to the shaking or even tremoring. For example, if at all you happen to visit the Seven Forks Dams, you get that just next to them, there is the shaking, trembling of the earth. Number two, explosive used in mines and roads construction. Now, when construction of road is carried out, there is the explosive that are being used. And that one results to the shaking and trembling of the earth. Number three, movement of the underground trains. This one results to the shaking of the crust of rocks. Number four, it is the explosion from nuclear tests. What that causes the earthquake. As you can be able to see, we have the large reservoirs. We also have the mining when it is taking place. We also have the main areas where earthquake is, our distribution of the earthquake. You can be able to see where it is distributed. Most of these areas, it is where we end the plate movement, the plate tectonic, the boundaries, especially the conservative boundary. Activity, define the term earthquake. Number two, explain four causes of the earthquake. If at all you want to refer, you can get the KLB book 2, 2003, that edition. You can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Erim TV.